Bonjour, Endo Academy. I am Gianluca Plotino from Rome, Italy. And the question I have to reply today is glypap or preflaring? What are we talking about? This is a very important topic in endodontic instrumentation because the first initial phase of the root canal preparation, represented by the scouting and the management of the glypap, is probably the secret of the success of this phase. The management of this initial scouting is probably also the most difficult part of the endodontic instrumentation, and an error that may occur in this phase may create problems for all the root canal treatment. When we have to speak about this topic, we have to start about definitions, because it is not so well established and well known what are the definitions of these terms. And when we are defining glypap, it's curious that this definition comes from an aeronautical field, because the glypap is defined as the approach path of an aircraft when it is landing, and it's usually defined by a radar beam. And the other curiosity is that the terms with which this glypap is defined in this aeronautical field. These terms are smooth and effortless. This glide path should the aircraft should move silently and in a smooth and effortless way. And those terms are the terms that we very well know in the definition of the glide path given by West, in which the glide path is defined as a smooth radicular channel from the canal orifice to the canal physiological terminus. And it is defined that it must be obtained in an effortless way. But when we are speaking about glypap, we are also to define the negotiation and scouting phase and the preflaring phase to avoid confusion. Because the scouting and negotiation phase can be defined as the exploration of the root canal to obtain information of the anatomy, geometry and the clinical reality, checking the permeability to the terminus of the root canals. This is a phase very important, but just to understand the root canal anatomy. And not to prepare the root canal. The glide path instead, as we have been defined by John West, can follow what I have called the 10 rule. That means that a glide path is established when a side stem, stainless steel, not pre-bent file, can arrive to the working length, predictable and in a repeatable way and in an effortless way. Most of our cases, most of our canal, have already a glide path present with this characteristic, more than 85% of the root canals. The preflaring, instead, is defined as a preliminary use of the manual stainless steel instruments, usually size 15, 20, 25, to enlarge the root canal up to the dimension of the tip of the first nickel titanium rotary file that must be used in order to prevent its blockage and to prevent the tapering. So the preflaring has been introduced to reduce the fracture by torsion of a rotary file, reducing the taper lock of the tip of these instruments. So the rule in our treatments is always to start with scouting with a small and not pre-bent stainless steel file, usually number 6 or number 8, just to understand the anatomy, to study the orientation of the root canal, if the root canal is large or strict, the trajectory of the root canal, just to study the anatomy. If the root canal is successfully negotiated during the scouting up to the working length, it means that a natural glide path is already present, because the vessels and the nerves create this natural glide path that can be negotiated by our instruments. So it's easy to create, to have a glide path when a natural glide path is already present, and this has an advantage that we can immediately start with mechanical files, limiting the use of more rigid stainless steel files and reducing possible error to their use. But when we are speaking about mechanical glide path instruments today on the market, we have to say that the instruction given by the manufacturer says that all these files are recommended to be used after the manual glide path with a stainless steel side stem instrument. This means that these are not really glide path instruments, but they are preferring file given the definition that we have done. Because the glide path has already been established by a side stem stainless steel file, and these instruments are only pre-enlarging the canal before the use of other mechanical files. So we can say that these mechanical glide path files represents only the first mechanical file of a sequence, even if it is not a file of a sequence but named in a different way. What do we really need in our clinical practice to improve prognosis of our treatments? We really need a scouting file, a file that does the initial phase of the negotiation of the root canal, that permits to negotiate difficult root canal and simultaneously form the glide path in a safe, effective and predictable way. This happens in around 15% of the root canals that we treat, that we need to do something more to obtain a glide path because the natural glide path is not already present. Clinicians have to form it, and this definition makes for me the classification of complex cases of primary endodontic treatments, because if we have the natural glide path present, for me they are standard cases, but if we have not a natural glide path present and we have to form it, those are really complex cases. Thank you very much, Endo Academy, for this possibility to speak about this topic, and see you soon. Ciao from Rome.